All right, it's live. Oh, we're on. Hi.
Oh, hi. I'm Chelsea.
And I'm Tony North.
And you're watching News, Booze, and Reviews. And this episode is brought to you by Squarespace, the all-in-one platform for creating a fast and easy professional website or online portfolio. And if you want to try that out, you can get it for 14 days for free, no credit cards needed. And if you decide that you like it and you want to buy it, go to squarespace.com/Tony and you can get 10% off with the coupon code PHOTOLIVE.
You can try it out, no coupon code required. It's awesome. It's where we host our pictures. They make your pictures look better. And
They
it's
make
cheap.
mine look better.
You can set up a store. Anyway, thanks Squarespace for
You
sponsoring
can
us.
check mine out at chelseanorthrup.com. You're going to be like, what? I need a Squarespace. Actually, when they first started sponsoring us, they just gave you one. And I saw it and I was like, I want that.
Yeah,
I got
they're awesome.
jelly, got a little bit jelly. Today's show, our photo theme is going to be events, so weddings, parties, stuff like that.
Yeah, it's kind of a holiday thing because when you get the families together, you're always kind of trying to capture the Thanksgiving dinner or opening the presents or whatever it is. So it's any sort of event. It's very much a storytelling thing. Like you're not just taking a portrait of somebody and kind of capturing their state, but you're documenting the process. You're capturing emotions and documenting actual facts and the story as it unfolds. It's an exciting and fast-paced type of photography. So we want to see your event photography. Submit it at sdp.io/submit.
The A72.
Yes, that's why we're late because we were filming that today. We went to the Mystic Aquarium. I just wanted to show this snapshot that it's actually a still from the video that Justin captured.
I made friends with this beluga whale.
And it was so cute because you took pictures of him and then showed him the back of the camera, and he was most definitely looking at it. It was hard to miss because he put his little
He put
eye
his eye right
right up
up
against
to it.
the, yeah. He was definitely checking out the
I
camera and
know.
looking at
He
it.
was like, I look good.
Yeah,
I
but
think he.
he said mirrorless cameras suck and I should get a DSLR. I thought that
He
was, no, he just squeaked some.
was like, I learned his language.
Camera snobs, those belugas.
Belugas, all the same.
I wanted to cover a couple of news points before we get into looking at
This is
pictures.
a graph.
You love
People
graphs and
love
charts.
graphs, not just me, everybody.
Yeah, because it's better than reading, right? The alternative is looking at a bunch of words.
I don't even have to read this.
This has colors, and
Colors.
I just thought it was interesting because this is like camera sales going back to 1933, when
What?
cameras were really difficult and not many people were buying them. And then these gray bars here are the sales of analog cameras, so film cameras, and you can see they kind of peaked right about 1997, 1998. Photography was really popular. That's when I got started
I
too.
wouldn't have guessed that. Wow.
But then digital cameras came in, and at first, only the nerds had them, and most people were still
You,
buying
did you
film
have
cameras.
one?
I was a late adopter with the digital stuff.
No.
Yeah, well,
I
maybe
don't.
not that late, but.
When you say late, he's like, I waited 6 months before I bought the very first one.
I was scanning film for a long time, so I was
Yeah.
working digitally, but capturing on film. Anyway, and then we saw the blue here are just point and shoot cameras, and then the green bars are when the digital SLR started to come in. So you can see the digital SLRs didn't come in until like 2003 or so. And then grew in popularity pretty quickly. The blue bars here are the point and shoot digital cameras, but they've almost completely fallen off. Like what they've dropped like 75% or so since 2011, just in the last few years,
And look at mirrorless.
because of smartphones, right?
Yeah, oh yeah.
Not, nobody needs a point-and-shoot camera anymore because we all just prefer a smartphone. I do. You have it with you all the time, and you can instantly put something on Facebook, so it makes perfect sense. It seems like the DSLR sales and mirrorless sales are kind of staying steady. If you're serious about photography, you're still using one of these, but sorry, point-and-shoot cameras are pretty much dead. I wish they would plot smartphone sales on there too. Photography's gotten bigger, in my opinion. Those charts make it look like photography's shrinking, but I think more and more people are involved.
Right.
Everyone is a photographer
Well,
now,
it's
every
not
single
a
person.
niche-y hobby anymore. I think before, if you had a camera, then you had to be into photography because it was a big investment.
Yeah.
And now everyone just has a camera on their phone.
I think it's so exciting because, and people are starting to appreciate it. They're taking vacation pictures and they're not turning out, or they're taking selfies and they look ugly. So they start to think about
I,
what techniques they could use.
yeah, and I get people all the time come up to me just like at the gym. There's a guy at the gym that's just like, hey, I heard you're into photography. Like, why is this picture? He brought out his DSLR, and he was like, oh, I'm sorry, it was his phone, but pictures from a DSLR. And he was like, why is this like this? And why is that like that? And people want to document their vacations in a better way.
Yeah.
We're like one-upping each other, and it kind of pushes people into photography. I'm like,
yeah, times
I have
are changing,
a book for
but...
you. I'm even plugging in real life. I'm like,
right at the
really?
Gym.
I can have a book for $9.99. That's why I have no friends. Not invited many places anymore.
This isn't a big time for new products to come out because it's a little late for holiday sales. But
is this thing for real?
Polaroid announced the Socialmatic, which will be out like January 1st. They just missed the line. They have a couple of kind of instant cameras, and I wanted to show it because we tried using an old Polaroid film camera last week, and it didn't work out at all. By the way, one of those pictures kind of turned out, but it turned out just terrible.
I left it upstairs. It was ugly
like we
anyway.
Exposed it properly. We did everything right, but this the film. They just the Impossible Project. I love them. I love the work they're doing, but it's not working out that
great.
Their name
says it all.
Anyway, this is a digital camera.
Damn. We're going to send them some aloe vera for that one.
Ouch. It just prints out little stickers.
Is this a huge camera or a tiny picture?
It's a teeny tiny picture. So I don't know exactly how big it is, but it's like this. And it also kind of connects to Facebook and stuff easily.
I'm going to say...
They're $300, which seems steep.
I'm going to say this one's not going to...
I'm still looking for that instant camera because there's nothing better than handing somebody a picture of themselves instantly. People get so excited,
yes.
Especially kids.
Yeah.
If we could just find one that worked well and was usable and inexpensive.
Maybe we'll see if they'll give us this and then we can see if it's worth it.
Yeah. I don't even know how to contact Polaroid. I think you need like a Ouija board.
That was funny and cruel. Put it up top.
I also just wanted to plug an iPhone app. They have it for Android too, but the Android one's outdated. Fuse, F-Y-U-S-E. Because this was a concept I'd been thinking about for a while, you can capture a subject from multiple angles.
Yeah.
And then look at it again when you hold up the phone, and as you move the phone around, it kind of rotates your point of view. So it kind of creates a 3D effect in camera.
That's cool.
And we just searched for it in your app store. Mm. I just wanted to plug it. It's free. Also wanted to talk about Yongno. Came out with an even cheaper version.
50-50.
I can't believe this. They took literally the cheapest lens you can buy, the $100 Canon 50mm f1.8, which we recommend all the time, and they made a $40 version of it.
I'm buying that.
So I gave you a link to Amazon where they sell them for like $60, but go to eBay, because you can get them direct from China, and they're $40 with shipping.
We need to get one. With shipping?
It was shipped. China like subsidizes shipping with their e-packet delivery, so
spooky.
We can't ship stuff that cheaply, but somehow China can. Yeah. Anyway, that's cool. I wish they would make it for Nikon and Sony and all these other companies, because they're the ones who really need a cheap 50mm, but now an even cheaper 50. I talked about that already. What's this, Chels?
The Vela One, the fastest LED flash in the world. It's actually a Kickstarter, so I knew you'd be like, no.
Means it's fake.
It could. It's not. Look at it. There's a picture of it right there. Oh, right. Oh, I'm blocking it. 1/2 millionth of a second. So pretty much could capture anything.
That's interesting. So your camera doesn't have to have a shutter speed of 1/2 millionth, because it won't.
No.
But you can just leave the shutter open in a black environment, and then this guy will just flash and provide enough light to expose the picture properly, I assume.
Yeah. They said it could capture a speeding bullet, but I think that's technically a BB.
Yeah, you're right.
That's cool.
Because
that's not that fast.
Bullets have their own propulsion, right?
Yeah.
Gah.
Gah. Gah, guys. $725.90.
Yeah, so check it out on Kickstarter if you hate your money. I just don't trust Kickstarter projects. They're fake.
So this was the picture that won the 2015 Sunny World Photography Awards, and it's called Orangutan and the Rain by Andrew Suriono.
That is an amazing shot.
Oh my gosh, it's so adorable. Do you think like a person taught him that, or he just knew that trick? What's happening? How do you learn that?
I don't think people had to teach him.
I bet Jane Goodall was like, just do this, stop getting wet.
God, if people could teach orangutan stuff like that, what could we could teach them to drive, and
I would teach it to
work
fan
in factories. The shutter speed is the most critical part of the shot, because he used just the right amount of shutter speed to show the motion and the rain. And it takes experimentation. If it's too fast, you're just going to see little tiny points.
Look at his little face.
And if it's too long, the rain disappears completely and it just looks blurry. Fantastic shot.
So good.
Yeah, should really be proud of that. Everybody says orangutan, right? You know people who put a G at the end?
Yeah, I do. I know that that's not right, but there's so many things I know aren't right, and I just keep making the same mistakes.
Oh, yeah, I said that for like 35 years.
Like I say button. And what's in the cup? Everybody's like, what are you drinking? So I decided to tell you. I made a concoction. Hot cider, some dark rum, and you put a little bit of allspice, nutmeg, cinnamon, orange, and you have yourself a wintry holiday treat. And if you can't drink because you ruined that for yourself or you're sickly or something, just have the cider. Is that wrong? I don't know. Let's just move on. Let's hope nobody heard that.
You ruined that. Speaking of ruining things, we're not going to be here next week because next week is Christmas and we celebrate Christmas, so we'll be with the family. You can tell Chelsea's not that excited about it. We're not kids at Christmas time anymore. It's mostly just a burden now.
Can't even guiltlessly eat sweets anymore.
You ruined it for yourself.
Chit-chat. This is the time of the show where we read your comments to us. This guy says, at first I thought, wow, I want me a girlfriend who could dress me just by snapping her fingers. Then I remembered Tony's vest and thought, maybe not. I just thought it was funny.
And it got 3 likes.
People love making fun of your clothes. I saw that.
I can't wait to hear what people have to say about my scarf.
I saw your scarf. I actually started laughing because I looked over and saw the scarf and I was like, he's done. He is done. You are cooked.
I just went for it. Like, I don't need to be wearing this indoors, but I thought, why not? I love it when people make fun of my outfits.
Saint Heart Knights, is the A7S full frame? Is it 4K? Does it do 120 frames per second at 1080p? Does it have 50? Whoa, you got a lot of questions. Let's just take this one at a time. Yes, it's full frame.
Oh, sorry, go ahead.
Does it have 4K? I actually don't know.
It's like yes and no. It doesn't record 4K to the memory card like the GH4 does. You can record it to an external device, but there's like no external device that can record it. Everybody's always like, you should use the A7S for 4K, but Atomos still has not released their digital recorder. We're first in line to get a loaner, but they're still like finalizing it. Mm. And so clearly they're having some problems. As soon as they start shipping those things, they've been talking about this for like 6 months. Yeah, we'll be there and we'll test it in 4K. So it should be 4K soon, but you have to buy this external recorder that's like $2,300.
What?
It costs more than the camera does.
Ooh, you should just get a different camera.
But did you see that footage of the A7S in low light?
Yes.
It's amazing.
It's crazy, yeah.
Yeah, and you can pick up the A7S and go like look at the stars.
We watched a meteor
and you can see galaxies
it,
and stuff.
And, yeah, it was like having night vision. It was so cool.
Yeah, that camera is such a cool toy.
I did see a galaxy.
Yeah, you can
a
see
a galaxy far away.
You get like superhuman eyes.
Superhuman eyes.
It does do 120 frames per second at 1080p, and it has 12 megapixels, not 50. He was right on the money. Yeah, no, nothing really 645Z does, but.
Tony, the camera whisperer, looks as a brother to the dog whisperer, Caesar Milan. I like your info about the 70D. Nice info. I just thought.
Just another guy. It's been a while since we talked about Caesar Milan. It used to be a daily occurrence.
I just like to bring it back around.
Yeah, I shaved my goatee, so I don't hear it that much.
Oh, I see. Oh, I wanted to look at some of the pictures.
Okay. First, before we started the show, I loaded up pictures that either we didn't get to last week or that people uploaded in the interim. This is a good chance to look at thumbnails because most important part of modern photography is the thumbnail. You have to make a thumbnail that catches people's eyes.
What about the one that says, this is Tigar's photo, don't disqualify me?
Yeah, that one caught my eye too. This is my favorite style of photography where you have a blurry picture and you write words over it, so. Congrats,
it's
Tigar.
It's not blurry, it's just silhouetted.
Okay, you're right, and artistic. And this one definitely caught my eye, too. This is just important work.
Who is that handsome gentleman?
Chelsea, it's a cat. Look at him, he's really cute. Really zoomed in there.
Stop zooming in on baby nipples, you creep.
He's cute. What else catches your eye?
Oh my gosh, he looks
very
startled.
Prairie dogs are adorable. Nice A77. Where I just wanted to see these guys with Oh, I guess those are instruments. I thought they just had like the...
That's illegal in Colorado.
The biggest bongs in the world.
Let's go on the dog in the bushes. What is he doing in there?
I
don't trust him. Do you?
I do not know.
What a creep. He's probably spying on other girl dogs.
Yeah, he looks like a real creep.
The owl's pretty.
Yeah, he's beautiful. Barn owl, I think.
Oh.
Okay. People, one picture per person.
Okay.
Oh,
marry
great.
Me,
a proposal.
Chelsea. I'm already married. Do you do dishes?
What, is that all it would take? I do the dishes all the time.
Never hurts to have two people doing dishes. Have you seen how many dishes we make?
You're right. Maybe I'll do like a sister wives type thing. Just somebody to work on the dishes. Another good owl picture.
Sister wives.
Oh, look at this one.
Great reference.
A little osprey and HDR. Nicely done.
Look at that shy parrot.
Okay, lots of owl pictures. Let's import the current pictures while Chelsea talks about something.
Oh my gosh, you guys, that beluga today was adorable. He was talking to us. Justin, you have to get more pictures. Remember I put up my hand and he tried to eat it? All the greatest friends do that. Oh, and today we recorded a video on getting a nice, smooth, blurry background.
Yeah, how to blur your background, get that bokeh.
Blur your background. Bokeh, whatever. You could get it.
So this isn't super eventy, but I do think they're trying to capture like the holiday decorations, and I feel like it's good. We just miss focus on the eyes, and I know they're fake, but it still kind of counts. But it's pretty close.
I don't think most people would notice that rule.
I think it's a good picture. Maybe it could be a little brighter. Maybe not that much.
That's nice. I like the lighting.
Cool shot. I'm having a hard time calling it an event,
in
but
Germany.
Sure, looks like
Zoom
it.
Zoom in on one of those. Oh yeah. I'm so jealous of the Germans. Germany's beautiful. Every time we go there, I'm like, man, it's like everything's out of it's like a miniature village or something in real life. It's so pretty.
Yeah, you feel like you're in Epcot Center or something.
Yeah, it's so
It really
nice.
is,
it
like
is.
You'd imagine it.
Oh my God.
And the Germans too, pretty much like you'd imagine them.
Yeah.
Anyway, beautiful long exposure. I love the blur on the carousel. Oh,
hey,
that's
Tivoli.
Yeah. We've been there. Also not an event, but we have been there.
We actually got a place right. Another high five. 2-1 show.
According to us, we could still be wrong.
It did say Tivoli, so.
Oh, right. Okay, so here we have an event, and this is really challenging lighting. You can see we have multiple different light sources here, but the people, the subjects seem to be properly lit. It was taken at a high ISO, and as a result, it ended up being kind of smeary and almost cartoonish when you zoom in. But
I like
out back,
the lighting,
it looks fine.
I like the atmosphere. It makes me wish we had like an office holiday party. It would be 3 people.
Four people.
Yeah. Well, Siobhan would be long distance.
Four and a half people.
Five. Four and a half.
Yeah, you're forgetting a lot of people.
Sorry.
Okay. Okay,
oh.
This is an event. Looks like a baptism, perhaps.
Wow, I like the movement in the water.
I do, too.
I think I'd bring out the shadows a little.
Oh, yeah, that's not a bad idea. My first thought was I'd love to see eyes, the face, the expression, because that is a kind of a key part of the storytelling. But at the same time, I like the water.
Yeah.
Oh,
boy.
That's just adorable.
Never get a toddler to hang your Christmas lights. They're bad at it. It's dangerous.
Nice natural light photo.
Oh.
Different person.
So cute.
It's really nice. She has kind of a nice like expression of anticipation there. I wish there were some presents in the background. That might be like a key part of the story.
I love this picture.
Yeah, I
the
do too. The
is
lighting
really
is really nice.
Unconventional.
Yeah.
I think a lot of people would say they don't like it, but there's something like very candid about it to me, and I think it can work.
Yeah, and with portraiture, we often end up recommending that people crop really tight around the face, even crop into the hairline. But here, the Christmas tree in the background is part of the story, and even her outfit with the candy canes is part of the story.
And her expression in her hands, she's almost like, is Santa coming, or was I good? I don't know.
And the choice to go to sepia is a good one, because I bet the Christmas tree was so brightly colored that it would have distracted you from the subject.
Yeah, this is very classic.
Anyway, yeah, great storytelling. You captured
it.
All the elements.
I don't know who you are, but you did it.
Okay, we'll call this an event. We have it looks like a rock band here, rocking out. Dude's got a plastic clothes hanger.
Well, yeah, that's what
and
you do.
He's definitely wearing a, a blouse, right?
Oh, no, that's a cami.
Okay, maybe it's a rock star thing. He also seems to have three legs. Is that like a rock star thing?
Yes.
He's got three legs, right? I'm just not.
Three legs.
I'm just trying to figure out where that other leg...
It's coming from the man behind him. It's not...
Oh, there is another leg. Wow, well, what's that guy doing with his leg between...
He's rock stars. They're unpredictable, Tony.
I'm baffled by... Okay, great shot of the three-legged man. I like the use of color here. Concerts are really difficult to get the color right because they always have multiple color light sources, so you just go for it. You can desaturate, but here, I don't think anything in the background is too distracting. You always end up shooting at a high ISO. That's just the way it is, but it turned out great.
Looks like it was a good time. Wow, I love that.
Yeah, beautiful, not an event. Okay, a race, an event. Okay. That could be a race. If it is a race, we would need to see some competitors as part of
the
storytelling.
Mud. Like, mud everywhere.
Yeah, and there's a certain intensity in the eye. I wouldn't mind cropping this down just quite a bit.
Take a drink.
We still need to... I love the rule of thirds and following the rule of space, but if we get a little closer, those dirt particles will become a bigger part of the frame. And as I zoom in, I can also see that the exposure is a little dark, so I'm just going to bring it up some. Just brighten it up. That'll help bring out the eyes some, too. A little sharpening wouldn't hurt you. But anyway, it turned out great. Love that you froze the action there. Another sport shot.
I wish I could see more. There's a lot of water at the bottom, but I think I'd like to see that up top part.
Yeah, so the balance is a little off because it's cropped so close to his head. And also, we're missing a key part of the storytelling because maybe you know that, a parasailing? Whatever he's doing.
No, it's like kite surfing or something. I don't really know.
Well, we don't know because that part of the story is missing. We need to see whatever he's holding on to.
It could be a flock of seagulls tied to strings.
Yeah, we don't know. That's what we need in the story.
Seagulls.
So it's okay if you're making a sequence of pictures to include tight shots, but we also need kind of an establishing shot.
This guy's wild. Oh.
This looks like it might actually be at a wedding or maybe an engagement shoot.
That's really nice.
Really sweet. It seems like it's a little soft, but maybe it's just that it's a high ISO. Anyway, it is a really sweet shot.
That's very sweet. Wow.
Oh, that's a beautiful shot. I love the bright colors.
I love that hair.
I feel like I want to pull this into the rule of space a little bit. I don't know. I like the wide angle effect. What do you think? Before or after? Oh, it never shows crop in that, but
something
to consider. Yeah, I love the contrast and the colors in it.
Yeah.
Another wedding shot here. You know, we have like a certain mood here that I feel like it should be supported with the processing too.
Yeah.
So maybe.
What do
I do? Let me see. You know, maybe something like this.
I wish I could read comments. Those were the days.
Oh, yeah. Well, do we have a comment sheet going, Justin?
We do.
Oh, okay.
Same one.
This is nice.
Do you need a laptop, Chelsea?
Or something? No, because I think that's far away and we can just read it on here.
Okay.
Yeah, let's pull it up. Beautiful shot.
Yeah, it's nice. I like it.
Great. I don't even know what else to say, but nicely done. I wouldn't do any edits to it. This one's a little bit underexposed. We want those clouds to be nice and bright and white.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah.
Pop, pop.
It could even use a little more contrast. I'll just up the clarity. Yeah, I don't want to go too far.
Don't go too crazy.
I just want to see a little more contrast in it. So if we do a before and after, it just has more pop. It was a little flat before. Easy enough to fix. We have a whole book on Lightroom.
Oh.
sdp.io/lr.
What is this wild man doing? That belt buckle and those actions, he is a loose cannon.
Yeah, he's just disappointing his father. That's what he's doing.
You don't know his father.
Neither does he.
Oh, that was too dark.
I don't know. He seems like an upstanding gentleman. I don't know why he's eating caution tape.
You don't know his story. I don't think you can stand here and judge. Maybe he's saving someone. He's making a tourniquet by making it smaller. That's the story I'm going with.
Well, he captured a moment.
He did. I like it. A christening.
Yeah.
Wow. What a contrast from the last picture.
I know, right? What do you want to do to this picture, Chels?
Maybe get rid of a little up here space. You go. You're the crop master.
Are you saying you'd want to crop it?
Well, I was saying get rid of up here space. It's a technical term. A lot of people don't know.
Up here space. Yeah, I'll get rid of some of the up here space.
This guy looks like Joey Lawrence, right? A little bit. Whoa. You know that one? Is that Joey Lawrence?
So glad we heard a Joey Lawrence impression. I think that's nice. You got people pretty close. That's the hardest part of group shots is getting people close enough. I wouldn't mind even seeing them squeeze in a little bit more and cropped a little tighter, but overall it's pretty good.
It's a really nice picture.
Yeah, it turned out just great. I feel uncomfortable with whatever she's holding in her hand.
It's called a candle.
And the kid here has her phone. One of the things you do is you just go through and get people to put stuff down.
Doesn't the kid always have the phone though, guys? Am I right?
Well, yeah, it's because we are so boring and their phone is so much more interesting.
Children.
Otherwise, great shot. The lighting turned out beautiful. Great exposure. Nice and sharp.
Do you remember when people used to say we were too nice and that you were like Ned Flanders and like all this other stuff and now we're just saying people and other fathers and...
Half a beer in and I'm just tearing people apart that I don't even know. Could have been the guy who submitted the picture.
He's like crying and come on, Tony. This is a nice picture.
Yeah. I want to crop this one too though.
Of course you do.
Now you want them it's still to be clear that they're at an event. So it's good to include some people in the background, but just enough to kind of tell the story. The rest of the frame you want to fill with the subject, and the subject here are their faces and their expressions. The lighting can be so difficult at events, but I feel like you nailed it. I feel like the skin tones are perfect and sharpness. The lighting is great, too. Maybe you added a bit of fill flash. I'm not sure, but either way, turned out great.
Oh, no. What happened?
I don't know. I've seen brides come in many different ways. Usually it's like in an old Bentley or a limousine or something. Never seen a wheelbarrow before. He doesn't seem to know what's going on either.
Yeah, but okay, let's talk about the photographer. I think they captured this moment.
Yes, I think they did too. I thought you were going to say something else after that.
This is interesting.
That's a cool shot.
That's not an
Amundsen, event. But
you tricked me. You almost got me. This is Bath in England. Oh. Am I right or am I right, guys? Tell me.
You're probably not right.
I went there. Oh no, what's he thinking about? Oh, that's not an event. Oh, look at this event. Just a bunch of drunk people looking for a hookup. This guy's taking
a
picture
of
himself.
Drunk,
she's like, I have a name, Brian, we're soulmates.
And they could be rolling.
Wearing a cowgirl hat, so we can't trust that one. She's the only sane one.
Yeah, she's just horrified by the
doing
whole situation.
With my life?
My dad would be so disappointed if I knew him.
You are all about disappointing fathers. I mean, let's just talk about...
It's that time of year, right?
Disappointing my dad.
This is the effect that happens when you use a flash. You kind of get this double effect. It's cool. I think it especially works well for parties.
Yeah, well, I think it's like replicating what they're seeing.
Yeah, I like it. It's often something you want to avoid with like a portrait, but her dad... What is he thinking right now?
I don't
now?
Want to talk about
dad. He's
dads.
Not happy.
Nobody cares about their dad.
Nobody cares about their dad. What if your dad is watching right now
my
and
dad,
crying a little bit?
My dad would be like, yeah, nobody. Because he doesn't care either.
What if Papa Jose is watching right now?
Papa Jose
You're just ruining
doesn't
your whole family.
Care about... He doesn't even care. Trust me.
What do you think, Chels?
She's sassy and she
is that the same? That's the same person. One shot per person.
Oh, it
has the same watermark.
Oh, well. This is a great shot.
Yeah, this is a great shot. I don't know why it's underexposed.
Oh my God, his dad must be so disappointed. There's a guy ahead of him.
I admire you for using such a slow shutter speed because you get the coolest shots when you use that slower shutter speed and show a little bit of the motion, but you're going to get so few keepers, right? You're going to have to take like 10 shots to get one that's even reasonable. So it's a risky move to use that slow shutter speed, but you pulled it off. It worked great.
Bold move, but it paid off.
Yeah. Like I'd want somebody else there using a fast shutter speed. Like I'd need
me?
A second photographer. It could be you.
Prefer if it was me. Oh, this is nice. Just showing off the table.
I think sometimes you want to kind of show the decorations, and that can be an important part of the story. There's the white balance feels off to me, though I'm not sure exactly what the color would be. It's difficult because we have natural light back here and probably incandescent light.
Auto, because this works well for me too.
Yeah, you're right. That I think that actually looked a little bit better.
One thing that works is, like, see how you're at a low angle here, so you see this front setting, and then most of the picture really is this window. If you had stood up a little higher and shot down at the table, then you would have had more of that. But it's still nice.
Yeah, and I find the person back here to be a bit of a distraction.
Oh, there's a person.
So compositionally, there are a few choices that you make here, and you put a little bit of a tilt on it, and I don't know if it was deliberate. It might be a Dutch tilt,
so.
Where you're trying to add some.
I like a little tilt.
Life to it. Tables tend to be organized symmetrically, so one thing you can do is move to the end of the table and shoot straight down it.
Insightful.
I'll even like move glasses around and kind of get perfect symmetry before
I
get the shot.
You're one to do that.
You do. You just have to take shots of the table decorations.
Yeah.
It can be more dynamic once the people come in. But they always screw up all the decorations and make it asymmetrical, which is just painful to see.
Oh my goodness. Oh no.
He's clearly broken some sort of law or something.
I think that he tried to report to the main office and they turned him away. Was it something I said?
That's really adorable.
The storytelling's great. This isn't an event, but look at us just talking about it. I guess it is an event. The biggest disappointment of his life.
Kid picture. Looking for event photos today.
That's not really an event, but it was nice. I like that. Hey.
Tivoli again. What's with all the Tivoli pictures?
Oh,
must
I
be the same guy.
I love Tivoli. Oh, that's so beautiful,
that's
but you
stunning,
know that's
but
not
an
even
event.
An event.
People say, okay, this could be an event, or at least it's closer to an event than the other things that we've seen. I love the rule of thirds composition here.
I guess the event was that guy went to Tivoli, but I mean, that's a stretch.
In fact, I'm going to pull this in even more to make it even more rule of 30.
Oh my God.
In fact, don't you even want to go deeper? Is it too deep?
Yeah, because I like his screen.
Yeah.
Right, Justin?
Yeah.
Justin,
really? You feel like
I think
I included
you,
some of the screen as
look,
like, part of the storytelling.
I think that you're a croptastic individual, but this time you've gone too far.
Hmm. Okay, I can own that.
I liked it before.
All right, fine. Anyway, great shot. One of the things you can do is move side to side to sort of balance the key elements of the photo. So if you were to move a little bit to the right, that would put more space between the light and the distance and your DJ here in the foreground. So maybe you could have separated them a little more and really aligned it with the rule of thirds. Just something to think about. You do need to see the partiers here to know that there's something going on.
I like
it's the key
partiers.
Part of the story. But just seeing them in silhouette is enough to tell that part of the story.
Tony and
cool
I know
shot.
A lot about partying. We just put on our cardigans and we just rave. We rave hard. This is cool.
Yeah. I don't know why.
Oh, this is the same event, I think.
Oh, you think?
Go back. Yep. See these sticks? And did these 7100.
You would know those sticks anywhere.
I knew these sticks. You almost got us, sir.
Used the fast a high ISO here, but it seemed to work. I hate to keep cropping, but this guy's elbow is in
no,
here. It kind of bothers
me.
No,
stop it. He already submitted one picture.
Okay,
you get
I'm sorry.
Nothing.
Well, now we skipped. This is some sort of
holiday-ish
event.
That's nice.
Yeah, that's a nice shot. Turned out great. It's beautiful.
We need the Willy Wonka that's like, you get nothing. Do you remember that part of the movie, Justin? You stole fizzy lifting drink.
I don't remember that.
You guys should watch that. Anyway, what's this event?
The holidays.
Baby's first
that.
Christmas?
Yeah, and I love that he's interacting with a tree. That ties it in. It draws your eye right back to the tree.
Did you really choose this ribbon? Is this a little tacky? Or I don't really think. I think I have that same ribbon, but I'm just saying. He looks judgmental.
Yeah, beautiful light, too. It looks like he broke out a beauty dish for it. It turned out fantastic,
and
really.
I love his outfit, how it matches.
I'm thinking about raising the shadows a little bit because the tree just falls off so much. I think they added vignetting, so maybe they wanted that, but do you feel like the tree could be a little?
No, I like
it. Maybe there's just too much vignetting for me.
Maybe.
Okay, food photography. It's really tough.
It's really tough.
To get food to look appetizing, especially because that's such a key part of the events that we go to.
That's really cool.
Yeah, I do feel like it's a little yellowish.
Yeah,
it's hard. One of those things that you have to kind of tweak.
You should undo that. Wait. Well, you want it to look on the warm side because then that makes the food look more appetizing.
Here's what I might do with the shot. I would slice it and have somebody putting the little pie servey thing that's shaped like a triangle.
And laughing while eating it. Like that.
It could be a close-up of the hands and just pulling a slice out, but it would make, it would provide a focal point and provide a little bit more storytelling than just a picture of the pie.
I wish that we could show them that pie picture we took where I added fake steam. Mm-hmm. The before and after. I wish I could show you that, but I can't. Wait, that's not an event, is it?
Well, we talked about capturing your holidays.
Okay.
That's beautiful, not an event.
Oh, look at that scared baby. Zoom in.
He sees something terrible behind the photographer that we can't see. That's an important part of storytelling.
He heard Santa's watching him when he's sleeping. He's cool with it. I like this picture. I think I'd bring out the tree just a little more, maybe?
Yeah, but as you raise shadows, it started to kind of reveal
the
too much. Yeah, the house and distractions.
Okay.
So
I like it. You win.
But they could go in more selectively and use the adjustment brush and just kind of bring out the lights and the tree a little bit.
I love their matching pajamas. Ooh.
Okay, so this is an event, like a protest.
Is it a little bit underexposed? People said maybe your monitor needed to be calibrated, but I think they were lying.
Well, but I'm not relying on the monitor. You should never rely on your monitor because we all have different monitors. I rely on the histogram up here. That's what you look at, and if there's nothing touching the right side,
I love the eye contact.
Then it's
really
underexposed.
Powerful.
Yeah, so this is an excellent example of street photography and a great job photojournalistically of capturing the event. You could crop it down tighter so it was more about her eyes.
Yeah, but then
you need to
the
see
crowd.
The people
yeah.
in the background. You need to see that they're also holding signs, or you would miss a key part of the story and you wouldn't know what the heck is going on. Great shot. I recognize that
background.
That looks really familiar.
Yep. I like it.
Yeah. I feel like the balance is a little off, though. Mm-hmm. Usually I like to see people's eyes up right at the top third.
Yeah.
And filling the frame as much as you can with their faces. With this particular shot, you always end up shooting at a higher ISO because you can't use strobes and use a low ISO or the Christmas lights will just get blown out.
Yeah.
Also, you want to watch the depth of field because
that's
I noticed...
It's really rough with this shoot because you have to get these lights in the background to show up.
Yeah. Which means you have to use a high ISO.
Yeah, you can't
add too much
your
front
light.
Lighting.
Your front light fighting with that light or else they don't show up.
Yeah.
But then you have to have like a higher aperture to get everyone in focus.
Mm-hmm.
But then you're cutting your light even more. So it's like, it's a tough photo shoot.
Yeah, as a general rule with group photos, you need to get everybody's eyes in focus. And I can see, I think you focused here on the girl in the middle and her eyes are razor sharp and his eyes are pretty good. He was about in the focal plane. That's one of the tricks. You kind of get people to lean forward or back.
But the truth is,
look at this kid. He missed the focal plane.
He looked like he was moving a little bit. But the truth is, like, most people are just putting these on a Christmas card or something, and it's good enough. It's going to be small.
Yeah, and the fact is I see professionally shot photos all the time where some people's faces are out of focus, and the people still seem happy with it. Anyway, what I'm saying is I'm kind of a perfectionist. But if you use a higher f-stop, you can get everybody's face in focus. Now, the challenge with that is the background suddenly becomes nice and sharp. And with this, you did want the background to be blurred, so you offset that by putting more distance between your subjects and the background. But to do that, you then need a bigger and bigger backdrop, which means you need a bigger and bigger room. So it's all these different things that you have to balance, the light, depth of field, the size of the background,
the size of the room. I should do a different video, because that one was actually really challenging, technically. And
yes.
I think I could do a lot simpler one, so I should line that up for next year.
Yeah, that's a good idea. But you're right, it is difficult, because there are so many things that are just even harder to describe. Like, it really requires a mastery of all the basics of photography, including lighting and depth of field. Maybe we should pop out of this and see if anybody has any comments. If I can remember how to see the comments. Talk, Chelsea, or Justin.
Justin! Where Justin tells you his feelings.
My camera's not working, so audio
Justin's
only. Pretty boring.
Well,
but your mic is working.
Yeah.
Got to look on the bright
Chelsea
side.
Chelsea dresses Tony. What does she have against colors? I don't like colors. They're ugly.
Yeah. Just kind of racist that way. Jeremy Burlett, I have a 60D and I'm looking to upgrade to do motocross photography. Should I get the 70 Mark II or get a 70D and a 400mm 5.6? Well, if you have to pick between the 70D and a 400 5.6 or the 70 Mark II and no lens, get the 70D. I don't know that the 70D is going to get you anything over a used 70, though. Mm-hmm. You can get a used 70 now for like $500 or $600. It's about the best deal out there. The 70 Mark II is vastly better. Yeah. It's 10 frames a second. We were using it just today, and the focus is amazing, and it's so fast. It's the best sports camera ever made. It's absolutely amazing. So if you have the budget for that and the big prime lens, you'll get amazing results. But otherwise, just go for the 7.
Alexandria Meyer says, have a happy Christmas. We will miss you guys. Chelsea looks so nice, and it looks cool, Tony. I like the scarf. Very festive. I think you look so cute.
Why, thank you for not busting me about my clothes for once.
Ross du jour. Oh, the Ross of the day. Tony's got that Burberry meets Velveeta autumn-winter campaign look going on. Next thing you know, he's being photographed by Merton Marcus and Karl Lagerfeld. I don't know that.
I don't know them either. Levi.
You know him? Levi.
He's had problems getting his book.
Yeah.
Just needs to add a crop black and white scoreboard at the top of the screen. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. Just somebody keeping track how many crops there are. We'll be able to know how many people have passed out from taking shots.
Bikezilla said, oh, they took Chelsea's computer away because she laughed too much when she reads the comments. That's true. People were so mad at me for that Sony review you did.
Yeah.
Everyone was just making like crotch jokes, and I just couldn't stop.
Yeah, because you're a 10-year-old boy.
It's my favorite.
Eric wants to see Justin wave at the camera, and unfortunately his camera's broken, so he'll just have to hop up at some point and wave at the camera. Maybe at the end of the show he'll do that.
Oh, you poor Brits. We said that we were going to be away on holiday, and they thought we meant like a vacation.
Well, we said holiday pictures.
Oh,
and I forget people in Europe.
Vacation pictures.
Yeah. So, yeah, we meant like Christmas or whatever.
Hanukkah, Kwanzaa, New Year.
Yeah. It means not going to work, but not going on a trip.
Part of storytelling is to scare the baby. He's cropping the pie. He did want to crop that pie. He's like,
Maybe we should take a quick look at a portfolio. Let me just see.
Wait, what? We're doing that?
Don't look happy.
You don't want to look at a portfolio?
No, we can. You really threw me a curveball there.
Well, we need to do a mid-roll where we talk about how awesome
Squarespace.
Our sponsor Squarespace is.
Well, you could... guys, do you know how we make this show? No, we can't fund it ourselves. We leave that to Squarespace, the all-in-one platform for creating a fast and easy portfolio. Tony has one, and I have one. You can check them out at Tony Northrop. Are you TonyNorthrop.com?
Or NorthropPhotography.com.
Oh, I'm ChelseaNorthrop.com. And they have really clean interfaces. They're easy to use. They have great 24/7 customer support. And they just make your pictures look great. So let's look at a few.
This is a Squarespace portfolio. Dora Resnick, portraits, miscellaneous, and shows. What do you feel like, Chels?
I love this picture.
Oh,
it's like Rock Bride.
Here. Yeah, it is really cool. It has a really cool mood. The lighting and color and processing and her expression all fit
mm-hmm.
together.
Yeah.
Same with that. It's all about the mood. This person's capturing the mood just great. Very mysterious with suddenly no eye contact,
yeah.
Right? It would be hard to call it a portrait without eye contact, but I do find the picture really compelling. I like whatever is kind of going on at the bottom there. It feels like kind of an old film, like
yeah.
processing error, like light leaked in, like from one of those crappy film cameras that people still use today.
Holga?
Because light, like a Holga, yeah, that's what I was the word I was looking for.
I love her expression.
Yeah, we have. I don't know. What's going
Who
on?
Who is this person? Let's go to the about.
I like the what's going on at the bottom here. I don't know if that's a double exposure of some kind or if it's reflecting off a foreground subject. He's in Israel. He's 18 years young.
Whoa.
and he loves photography. Okay.
He's cool.
He doesn't seem to be trying to sell his work, but it looks great. It looks professional worthy. It's very artistic.
I love that.
Yeah, I love the mood. I love this shot too. Again, we have some snow or something in the air, but it adds a lot of life to it. Her expression is just great. You're getting a lot out of the models.
You're getting great expressions out of your models, and that's so important.
Oh, that's the hardest thing. That's the single thing that brings down most portraits.
It's such a bummer when you get a whole shoot set up and then your model just thinks this is good. They're like, you're like, please stop.
Yeah.
Just don't think about that.
They're like, my whole life people have told me I'm a model. I should be a model. So this is, I'll just, no. It's hard to be a model.
Siobhan's a good model.
Yeah. Siobhan is a really good model. And you found some really good models too. Like, see.
This girl's beautiful.
Yeah. And she's bringing an intensity. She's bringing expression.
She's also just really interesting looking. I love her freckles and her eyebrows. She's beautiful.
Yeah.
That's another thing. I love that his models are all different. A lot of, I hate to, I don't want to sound sexist, but I think it's common that a lot of men just pick the women as models that they're attracted to. And I think that that can be maybe a mistake, because sometimes it's the women that are less conventionally pretty that make a really striking photograph. And if you look at models, a lot of the time they have like a really strong jaw or like very different coloring or something, something that makes them look different. It's going to make your photo pop. So don't just pick the model you think is hot. Pick a model that's going to look really interesting on film, has strong bone structure or something like that.
Yeah, in fact, when they refer to like a fashion model, they refer to somebody with interesting features. If they say a model is commercial, they mean that they look like the chick in the JCPenney. You know, they're blonde and they have European features and they just look attractive but kind of
ordinary. Unoffensive, basically.
A commercial model is perfect for stock photography.
Yeah.
But for fashion or fine art, you want somebody more interesting looking. And they might not even be conventionally attractive. I just pause on the shot because I absolutely love it.
Yeah, I love it too.
I think it's fantastic. I also like that this is not the glamour work. We see so much just glamour work. Great shots. I wonder what he does for miscellaneous.
He's so good at just capturing people. Oh, that's beautiful.
That is really beautiful. I love the use of symmetry here. And as we were talking about with the events, so much of it is the storytelling, mm-hmm. and he really told the story with the scene. Great processing.
This kid's only 18. He's going to be sick if he keeps practicing.
I know. Some of the best portfolios we see are from young people. And I want to just make a note and check back in 5 years or 10 years and see where they are. Dor, we absolutely love your work. You're doing great work. Okay. He has this labeled under shows. I don't understand what the show here is. Or maybe he put on a show of his own work. This looks kind of like street photography.
Ooh, that's nice. All right. Well, I think that you have great pictures. I just want to keep looking through it. Your portfolio is nice and clean. I love the layout. It's great. I actually don't have any constructive criticism.
No, we usually end up giving a lot of homework to people. Here's what Dor had to say. I love it. Very comfortable and user-friendly and great customer support. That was for Squarespace.
Yeah.
You can go to squarespace.com/Tony.
Get your own
portfolio. And if you want 10% off after your 14-day free trial, no credit card required, use the coupon code PHOTOLIVE. That doesn't give us any money, but it gives us credit, and maybe they'll keep sponsoring our show so we can keep doing this and looking at your pictures. Let's take another quick look at somebody else's portfolio. John Hu Craig. It's got the GBH going on here. I feel like he recovered the highlights a little bit, though, and this should be like perfectly white, but let's check out his work.
Okay. What's happening?
It's going for thumbnails, which is good. It lets us kind of easily assess what we want to look at. Just kind of a mishmash of different types
of
photography.
Let's go all the way to the left middle, the blue jay.
Okay. Nice shot.
Mm-hmm.
I might even raise the shadows in the eye a little bit.
I like his pose and everything. I just wish he had that little catchlight in his eye.
Yeah.
I like the shadow on his back too. Orchids.
Let's see if I can. There we go. Chipmunks are cute.
Chipmunks.
Old Canada goose. Yeah, great shot. You definitely don't have too many pictures. At this point, I would just say mostly just keep shooting. Oh, look, he's got photos for sale because every Squarespace site allows you to set up a store.
Fancy.
And it works really well. You've been using it to sell t-shirts. I don't know if you still have t-shirts for sale.
Yeah, ChelseaNorthrup.com. We have some left. They sold out really fast.
Ah, okay.
So
NJHC has pricing here, and it looks like you can even click on it to find out more information and pay for it online. So that's part of the great parts of having a Squarespace portfolio. You can buy photo cards, right, Foam? Anyway, nice work, and thanks for submitting your portfolio. Here's what he had to say about it. Squarespace is great. Customer support is helpful. Yeah, their customer support.
They're known for their good customer support. Always gets back to you really quickly. I haven't had to use it yet, though, so I can't speak to it personally.
Well, I used it because I'm not as smart as you.
No, but that's okay.
And they were really helpful.
I love you anyway.
Look at a few more photos. Here's a shot
taken
with a Nikon
D5300. Today I'm 8 months old.
Yeah, and actually that's important because it tells a key part of the story, and that's what it is all about, just knowing what's going on.
That's really cute.
To somebody who doesn't already know. Yeah, great. Perfect show exposure. I want to just do that and then recover the highlights a little bit because I don't want to blow out those highlights and the lights, but I wanted to raise the exposure on the face a little bit. Looks really nice.
That's funny. That's cute.
Yeah, I don't know what the story is, but okay. There's your stuffed animal at Christmas. This is trying to capture the, like, Christmas decorations, I think.
What is that? Is that a candle?
Well, I'm wondering that too. I'm not really sure. I think if you knew what it was, you would know what it was capturing, but
yeah,
there's not quite enough of it there for us to know what's going on. Maybe if we were already familiar with the product. yeah, baby holiday pictures are pretty cute. You caught him with his eyes open, which is great.
He looks like he's about to sleep. He's cute.
Beautiful lighting, clean background.
Yeah,
nice shot.
That's a beautiful picture. I love the colors he chose too. Oh, that's sweet.
Taking pictures of people getting pictures.
I think it's a little dark because it's hard to... I'd like to see the photographer. Oh, I see it was grainy. Okay.
I do not know what a Perfection V600 is. I've never seen that camera before.
Oh. Yeah. It's cute. Oh, this looks like... What is this?
Okay, so I think this is a Sweet 16 party.
Oh, okay.
I'm piecing that together because you can kind of see the balloons in the background. But again, this is the key part of the storytelling. The viewer doesn't know what's going on, so we end up kind of piecing it together. And I think you're in front of the balloons because that was supposed to tell the story, but at the same time, we can't really see enough of it.
Yeah.
So you might kind of plan around that. You did a great job of getting everybody together, which is hard. I would also suggest moving everybody away from the background.
Yeah.
Separation requires a big room, but it can be really helpful.
They have great expressions. I love the poses. I just brought up the shadows a little bit because you were losing the detail in the suit. Like you can see before here, it just kind of looks a little bit like a blob. So just, yeah, it looks nice.
You might also, I mean, it depends what how you're going to, if you're getting a print or something. Something like this often comes down to an 8x10 print. I wouldn't mind seeing it cropped horizontally because there's
crop
like,
off her fingers.
Hands are always kind of awkward. Yeah, so for me, the ideal is if you can squeeze everybody in close enough so that you can, like, keep their hands out of it. And this is too tight of a crop. We'd have to get these people to squeeze in a little tighter. Maybe
what?
Make two
Any
rows
tighter,
of people.
And they'd just be one weird person.
Well, you'd have to get some people, like, kneeling in front and make multiple rows. But you see what I mean in that it's a little awkward when you show too much of the bodies. The posing becomes a little too complex for a group to handle.
Okay. Well, I like it.
That's hard.
I like it.
It just turned out good. I just felt like I had some criticism I could provide.
Cute.
Yeah, that's really nice. Beautiful symmetry. Great shot. I like that a lot. That's really nice. Other people who thought we meant vacation. This is off level a little bit, so that should be fixed. I wish there were more of a foreground subject, but I'm interested in what's going on here because it seems to be a festive holiday party at like a major power plant or factory. What's going on with the background?
I don't know, but I like it.
But because we do have so much geometry in here, we have straight lines and buildings, perfect horizontal lines and vertical lines, we do need to make sure that those are nice and level. So just straighten those out or it becomes a distraction.
Oh, that's really cute.
Yeah, that's just a great wedding shot.
What a nice bride. Pampering her flower girl.
Yeah, that's sweet. Okay. Family event or some sort of camping event. I'm just thinking about what to say about it. We have all the elements of the store. We have tents in the background so we know what's going on. We see barbecue guy.
The light is so
working
rough
here,
which is not their fault.
No, and you just sometimes have to deal with that kind of light. It looks like these people back there have a yard of beer, so they're my kind of people. I don't know. I mean, I feel a little upset that her head is so close to the corner. And you could back up a little bit and maybe help with that, but then everything else gets smaller. If you were to move down, like crouch down a little bit, then these people would disappear.
Yeah.
This might be the best you could do given the situation. It's a hard situation with so many people.
What if you backlit everybody instead to make the light more even?
Oh, like going over to the other side?
Yeah.
Yeah, that might have worked. These people here are in the sun from over there. Those people are in
Yeah.
shadows. Yeah, that's something to consider. At the same time, getting all those people to look at the camera at the same time can be really hard.
Yeah.
It's a challenging situation, but I feel like you told the story. That's
Cool
good.
picture. Is that Lady Gaga?
That
Doesn't it look like her?
is a cool picture.
That is
I
cool.
do not know what the event is, but it's cool.
Maybe not an event.
Wow, look, we got through all
Oh my
the
gosh, we got through
important
all the
pictures.
pictures? So
Yeah,
cool.
well, I bet people have
It's
sent
six
in some more
o'clock.
pictures. Oh, it is. All right.
Perfection.
We'll take another quick look at.
Didn't have anything else in our slideshow, huh?
I don't know, do we?
Gotta stretch it out.
So let me see what else we might have
How
had.
about comments? I like those. Oh, I was just gonna plug some stuff. Nobody wants to hear that.
Okay. Do you know if guys know if Nikon is working on something? No, I don't know. What Nikon
Working
is
on
working
you.
on. It's not like they tell us, "Hey, Tony, we're working on this stuff." They would keep that
Oh,
stuff
this is the
secret.
kid with the lovely portfolio. Okay. Don't let it go to your head. Just teasing you.
Is the Sigma 30
Feeling.
millimeter f/1.4 a good portrait lens for Christmas shots? I would prefer longer focal lengths.
Oh,
So
yeah.
you could just get a 50 millimeter f/1.8 and it
Yeah.
would be cheap. I currently use a T2i. Should I upgrade lenses? I use primarily a Nifty 50 right now or upgrade my camera next. I was thinking of a 70 Mark II considering I work crop already. Should I jump to a 50 Mark III? We don't know what sort of photography you do.
Yeah, we'd have to know more
People
about
always
you.
ask this kind of general question, but yeah.
I think the most questions, if you look in our YouTube comments and messages and our inbox, we get so many questions about what gear to buy, and
Yeah.
people just think we're rude when we plug our buying guide, but it's just more efficient for us to write it in a book than to answer every single person. Like that would be our full-time job. So we
Because
should.
this is the way it goes. We always have to be like, okay, well, what sort of photography do you do? Okay, well, what's your budget? Like, would you rather do this or that?
Yeah.
But as I write all that out in the buying guide, that's why I had to write a whole book about it. But you
Well,
don't have to read
I
the whole
think we
book.
actually wanted to put thought in it because we could easily just be like, yeah, get the new camera, like use this link, and we would make a ton of money off of it. But we really want to just give genuine advice. So it's like, it's
I would feel
$9.99
awful if
for
I
our
told the
buying guide.
guy to
Yeah.
buy a $1,600 camera or a $2,000 camera and then it wasn't right for him. That's a lot of money. So anyway, yeah, that's why I'm suggesting you buy a $9 ebook.
If you don't like it, we give you your money back. So it's kind of risk-free.
Yeah.
Let's see what else. We need Team ISO vests at the store.
Not sure that would be
It wouldn't be popular.
a huge seller, but Levi says a firmware update came out for the 6D. That's good to know. There's also a firmware update out for the D810, and the XT1 came out with a firmware update. Lots of
Yeah.
little firmware updates out there.
I think that's it. We did it. We did it all.
Great.
So we won't see you next week, but thank you for watching. And if you like us, then come back or buy our books or send us a Christmas card.
Are we working 2 weeks from now? Because that's New Year's Day. January 1st.
What? Are we gonna be gone for that long?
I
Maybe
don't
we should
know.
just reschedule.
Yeah, who knows? Follow us on Twitter at Tony Northrup and at Chelsea Northrup, and we'll
North
let you
Rue.
know when the next show is.
Not that
But
special.
it's definitely not next Thursday because that's Christmas. So thanks so much for submitting your
Yep.
pictures. Happy holidays and a happy new year if we don't see you before then.
Thanks.
Take care, guys.